हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ दीपिका राणा फ्रॉम डी आर फिजिका चैनल. वेलकम टू ऑल इन दिस चैनल. इन टूडेज वीडियो लेक्चर आई विल सॉल्व सम न्यूमेरिकल्स बेस्ड ऑन प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन. एंड दिस न्यूमेरिकल्स इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर योर अपकमिंग एग्जाम. सो वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड. एंड येस, इफ यू आर न्यू फॉर दिस थ्योरी, देन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल चेक द डेरिवेशन ऑफ दिस फार्मूला used in the numericals. I have kept link in the description box. So let's get start. Question is, equation of trajectory of projectile is y equals to under root 3 into x minus 0.8 into x square. Here x and y in meter and g equals to 10 meter per second square. From this question, we want to determine initial velocity of projectile, range of projectile, time of flight, and maximum height. First of all, we will collect all data from the question. Here y equals to under root 3 into x minus 0.8 x square. It's given. Let us compare this equation with the equation of trajectory of projectile. Here, equation of trajectory of projectile is y equals to tan theta naught into x minus g upon 2 u square. Here, u is a initial velocity, u square into cos square theta naught into x square. Now, let us comparing the first term and the second term individually. Here, first term is root 3 equals to tan theta naught. And therefore, theta naught equals to 10 inverse root 3. As we know that 10 60 degree equals to root 3. So put the value of 10 60 degree in place of root 3. We get 10 inverse into 10 60 degree. Here 10 into 10 inverse is got. So the theta naught equals to 60 degree. Let us comparing the second term. Here second term is 0.8 equals to g upon 2 into u square into cos square theta naught. Here we want to determine initial velocity, so we have to subject to u here, and therefore u square equals to g is as it is, whole divided by 0.8 goes into the numerator and multiply with 2. We get 2 multiply 0.8 multiply cos square theta naught is as it is. Let it substitute the values in this equation. We get 10 whole divided by 2 multiply 0.8 multiply cos square is as it is, and theta naught equals to 60 degree. Put the value of cos 60 degree. As we know that cos 60 degree equals to 1 upon 2. So 1 upon 2 here square, so square is as it is, and square of 1 upon 2 is 1 upon 4. After calculating all terms, u square equals to 25 and initial velocity u equals to 5 meter per second. Let us determine the range of projectile, and using the equation of range of projectile is u square into sine 2 theta whole divided by g. Let us substitute the values in this equation. Here u square equals to 25, sine 2 is as it is, and theta equals to 60 degree, whole divided by g equals to 10. And here 2 multiply 60 degree equals to 120 degree, and 10 is as it is. And the value of sine 120 degree equals to root 3 by 2. Let us put the value of sine 120 degree. We get 25 multiply root 3 by 2 multiply 10 is as it is. After calculating this all terms, we get range of projectile r equal to 5 root 3 by 4, and the unit of range of projectile is meter. Now let us find out the time of flight. In the equation of time of flight, t of f equals to 2 into u sine theta divided by g. Now let us put the values in this equation. We get 2 is as it is, initial velocity u equals to 5, and sine is as it is, theta equals to 60 degree, whole divided by g equals to 10. Now here 2 y's are 10, so 10, 10 cut. The remaining term is sine 60 degree. And the value of sine 60 degree equal to root 3 by 2. And the value of time of light, t of f equals to root 3 by 2. And the unit of time of light is second. Now, let us determine the value of maximum height. And the equation of maximum height is h equals to u square into sine square theta divided by 2g. Now substitute the values in this equation. U equal to phi square is as it is, sine square is as it is, theta equals to 60 degree divided by 2 into g equals to 10. Further solve, phi square equals to 25, sine 60 degree, value of sine 60 degree equals to root 3 by 2 and square is as it is, whole divided by 2 tens are 20. Here 25 divided by 20 equals to 5 divided by 4 and the square of root 3 by 2 equals to 3 by 4. Now let's take the product of numerator and denominator. Here 5 threes are 15 divided by 4 fours are 16. And the value of maximum height capital H equals to 15 divided by 16 and the unit of maximum height is meter. Let us move the second question. And the question is, a projectile is fired from the surface of the earth with a velocity of 5 meter per second and angle theta with the horizontal. Another projectile fired from the another planet with the velocity of 3 meter per second at the same angle follows a trajectory which is identical with the trajectory of a projectile fired from the earth. The value of the acceleration due to the gravity on the planet is dash. Here g equals to 9.8 meter per second square is given. First of all, read the question very carefully and collect all data from the question. Here maximum range is equal because both projectiles have a same trajectory. And therefore, maximum range of the first projectile equals to maximum range of the second projectile. Now using the equation of maximum range, for the first projectile is u1 square upon g1 is equals to u2 square upon g2. Now let us substitute the values in this equation. Here u1 equals to 5 and g of 1 equals to 9.8. So the 5 square whole divided by 9.8 is equal to u2 equals to 3. So 3 square and g of 2 is as it is. From this question, we want to determine the value of acceleration due to the gravity on the planet. So we have to subtract g of 2. So g of 2 equals to 3 square multiply 9.8 whole divided by 5 square. After calculating this all terms, we get g of 2 equals to 3.528. And the value of the acceleration due to gravity on the planet is g of 2 equals to 3.5 and the unit is meter per second square. Let's move the next question, and the question is, if the maximum height achieved by the projectile particle is half of the range covered, that is h equals to half of the range, then the projection angle is dash with the horizontal. Let us consider theta is the angle of projection and here the maximum height achieved by the projectile particle is half of the range covered. That is h equals to half of r. It's given. That is h equals to r by 2. Now using the equation of maximum height, u square into sine square theta divided by 2g is equal to half is as it is. And using the equation of range of projectile, and the equation of range of projectile is u square is the initial velocity, u square into sine 2 theta whole divided by g. Here u square cut, g, g cut, and 2 also cut. Now the remaining term is sine square theta is equal to sine 2 theta is as it is. Now split the sine square theta. So the sine square theta equals to sine theta into sine theta. Now using the equation of sine 2 theta, and the equation of sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta into cos theta. Here sine theta cut, and the remaining term is sine theta equal to 2 cos theta. Now this cos theta goes into the denominator. It will become sine theta upon cos theta is equals to 2. And sine theta upon cos theta equals to 10 theta, that is equals to 2 is as it is. Now we want to determine the projection angle theta. So the theta equals to 10 inverse 2. Let's move the next question. And the question is, an object is projected with a projection angle such that its range becomes twice of its maximum height. Then its projection angle is dash. Read the question very carefully. Here, range becomes twice of its maximum height. Let us consider theta is the angle of projection, and small u, that is u is a initial velocity. Here we are given range becomes thrice of its maximum height. That is range r equals to thrice means 3 into the maximum height, that is equals to capital H. Now from the question we are given r equals to 3 into H. Now using the equation of range and the maximum height, here equation of range is u square into sine 2 theta whole divided by g is equal to 3 is as it is, and equation of maximum height is u square into sine square theta whole divided by 2 into g. Here u square cut, g also cut, and the remaining term is sine 2 theta, and the equation of sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta into cos theta is equal to 3 is as it is. Sine square theta, that is equals to, we can write sine theta into sine theta in place of the sine square theta, divided by 2 is as it is. Now here sine theta also cut, and the remaining term is 4 by 3 into cos theta is equal to sine theta. Using the cross multiplication rule, cos theta goes into the denominator, and we got 4 by 3 is equals to sine theta upon cos theta. As we know that sine theta upon cos theta equals to 10 theta. So 4 by 3 is equals to 10 theta. And theta equals to 10 inverse 4 by 3. Further solve, 4 by 3 equals to 1.33, and therefore theta equals to 10 inverse in bracket 1.33. Using the natural log, 1.333 is the value of 10.53 degree 8 minute, and the angle of projection is 53 degree 8 minute. Here are some MCQs based on the projectile motion. Try to solve this all MCQs and give your answer by commenting. And if you have any doubt related to this topic, you can ask by commenting without any hesitation. Thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video lecture. Have a nice day.